Well, he hit the Aussie pop charts in the 60s and 70s with songs like Smiley, The Prophet, Exit Stage Right. Now Ronnie Burns is celebrating the first digital remaster of his back catalogue and he joins us now from Hobart. Put your hands together. Yeah. Ronnie,
Yay. Welcome.
Great
welcome to
see
Hobart
you.
Welcome to sunny Hobart in Van Diemen's Land. Welcome, Denise.
Great to see you, mate.
Yes, it's great to hear you.
Delay here, but take us back to those days, what it was like for a young bloke like yourself being thrust into the spotlight.
Well, this has been an important release for me because I'm actually going back to revisit all those days. And at that particular time, we had a lot of camaraderie. You would remember that there was John Farnham and Johnny Young and Colleen Hewitt and myself and all those people, Marty Rowan. And we were all sort of friends of each other's youth. So it's all come through to this point in time. We're still working together. And this album reflects the songs that I selected that I wanted to do at that time.
And Ronnie, one of the biggest stories in showbiz at the moment is they're making a mega movie about the Bee Gees. And you were actually good mates with the Gibb brothers. And they even wrote some songs for you. How did that come about?
Oh, they wrote a lot of songs. They wrote a whole album for me, but there was a lot of singles as well, like Exit Stage Right and Coal Man. I haven't seen Barry Gibb for quite some time, but I do remember he drove me around London in his convertible Rolls Royce, and I was smoking at that time. This is back in the 60s, and I must have flicked the cigarette out the open convertible, and it went into the back leather, and I went into the airport to come home, and the car caught fire.
Oh.
Oh, wow. And also, tell us about the time that you almost Barry Gibb.
That's right. It was I went to his place to stay for 2 weeks. I flew over to London to be with him and his future wife. And he took me down into this basement that was full of weaponry. So he collected swords and sabres and rifles. And there was a little window in the basement flat. And I said to him, "What is your most prized possession?" And he picked up this German Luger. So it was about the size of a matchbox. And the officers used to keep it in the top of their boot after they'd surrendered their pistols. So he gave it to me and said, "Just be careful, it's got a hair trigger." And so I took it off him, my finger touched the trigger, the bullet went off and just missed his cheek and smashed the window behind me. Needless to say, the blood just ran out of his face. I knew there would have been no, "You should be dancing." There would have been none of that. Anyway, I was a bad shot.
Ironically enough, given that story, one of the secrets to success in showbiz is longevity, and not a lot of people have it, certainly not when they're hanging around with you. How does it feel to have your music you listen to half a century later?
Well, it doesn't make me feel older, it makes me feel younger, because there's a new generation of people looking at this stuff, especially because of our technology we have these days. But it's been a fantastic journey, and a lot of those people are still going, which is wonderful. And I never thought I'd be doing an anthology.
Ronnie, I think we've lost Ronnie and our link to Hobart, but what a fantastic fella.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah, this is Ronnie Burns is the name of his album, digitally remastered, and it's out now. What a great bloke.
God, I'd love to be digitally mastered.
Oh, there he is. Thanks, Ronnie.
Thanks, Ronnie.